information.com webinar. Today we are going to interact with Mr. T.V. Radhakrishnan on pomegranate cultivation. And the format of this webinar will be as follows. I will mute everyone in the audience except Mr. Radhakrishnan. He will make his presentation. After we listen to him, we can ask him our questions. And you can ask your questions by typing your questions in the chat box, or you can also email me at ed@agricultureinformation.com. I repeat, ed@agricultureinformation.com, and I'll forward the same questions to Mr. Radhakrishnan. And if we have time, I may unmute one or two members in the audience so that you can directly talk to Mr. Radhakrishnan. Mr. Radhakrishnan, I'm unmuting you now. You can start your presentation. One second. Yeah, Mr. Radhakrishnan, you can start.
I am Radhakrishnan from Dutch Agri Farms. Actually, we have our office at Coimbatore. Then we have our office at Mumbai. We are doing pomegranate cultivation throughout the India. We are providing consultancy services to some corporate companies and some progressive farmers throughout the India. Actually, pomegranate. I will give my introduction about me. I am completed my agriculture graduation from Tamil Nadu Agricultural University in the year 1992. Then I was working with some several companies. I have around some 20 years of experience in the farming. Now, recently, some 2 years back, we started our organization called Dutch Agri Farms India. Now, in this session, I am going to tell about the pomegranate cultivation. Hello.
Please go ahead, Mr. Radhakrishnan. We are able to hear you. Hello.
I can continue, no?
Yeah, please continue. After we complete our. After you complete. Please continue.
Yeah. Actually, in India, the pomegranate is cultivated around 1 lakh hectares throughout India. But majorly, Maharashtra is cultivating around some 82,000 of hectares pomegranate in India. They are the major contributors. They are the major pomegranate growing farmers. They are in the Maharashtra. They are cultivating around 82,000 hectares of pomegranate, followed by Karnataka. In Karnataka, it is being cultivated in 13,000 hectares. Actually, if you see the production, the total production as per the last year statistics, it is around some 7,42,000 metric tons, which is the harvested. But Maharashtra is the plays a major role. Their contribution is around some 4,92,000 metric tons, followed by Karnataka. Karnataka, their production is around 1,42,000 metric tons of pomegranate. But if you see the productivity, Tamil Nadu is the in the productivity, Tamil Nadu is more. Per hectare in Tamil Nadu, it is 25 metric tons per hectare. It means 1,000 tons per acre, followed by Karnataka. In Karnataka, productivity is 10 metric tons per hectare. So this is the scenario. Actually, now I am going to deal with the high-tech pomegranate cultivation. Traditionally, in the pomegranate farming, they are keeping around some 700 plants per hectare. But as per the present situation, we are doing around some 400 plants per acre. It means around some 1000 plants per hectare. So, for high-tech pomegranate cultivation, we can maintain up to 400 plants per acre. So, actually, we are getting the yield from the second year onwards. In the second years, we can get around some 5 tons per acre. And it is increases every year. So, in the maximum, we can get around some 20 tons from 5th year onwards. Okay. Regarding to the cultivation, first we will go for nursery development. Actually, this pomegranate is being propagated by various methods. But first and foremost is air layering. Actually, in India, most of the nurseries, they are doing this air layering only. Air layering is the best method, followed by cuttings. Then very few of the companies, they are doing this tissue culture, this cultivation, tissue culture pomegranate multiplication. But it is very limited. In India, only some 2-3 companies are doing this pomegranate in the tissue culture method. So, but in the tissue culture method, you can get very good quality of seedlings. Then the regarding to the cultivation, actually we are providing consultants to the most of the farmers in the Maharashtra. We are keeping 13 by 9 feet distance. That is row to row we are keeping 13 feet distance, and plant to plant we are keeping 9 feet distance. So it will come around some 400 plants per acre. So we are keeping 400 plants per acre. This is the high-tech cultivation technology we are adopting. So we are allowing the plants to putting in the year of after 16 months we are allowing flowering. So at the end of second year we can start harvesting our yield. Very first year we can get around some 5 tons per acre. This will be increased every year. Maximum harvest we can get from the 7th, 6th year onwards. That means depending upon your care you are providing to your plantation, we can get yield from 10 tons to maximum of 20 tons per acre per annum. Actually, regarding the planting method, we are getting the seedlings from the nursery or from the tissue culture labs, and we are keeping the plants for hardening around some 2 months in the our existing site condition. So after just hardening, we are taking the plants for planting. Normally in the planting, we are making the plant with size of minimum 1 cubic feet we are maintaining. So after making the pits, we are filling the pits with the proper filling materials like our cow dung, then mother soil, then all other inputs. So after filling the materials, we are doing the planting. So after the planting, we can see the growth very rigorously. Actually, this pomegranate, it can, it is suitable for all type of soil, but it is highly suitable for sandy loam soils. In the sandy loam soil, its His performance is very good.
Regarding to the water application,
actually it can withstand drought condition, but its response is more if you apply very good water, then we can get very good yield. Normally our water requirement is around some 40 liters in the peak period of summer cultivation. So if we are able to give the 40 liters per plants, then we can get very good yield. Then after the planting, first is the training. Training means removal of the excess stems and other things. Normally we are allowing 3 to 4 stems per plant, so that each and every stem we can get around some 25 to 40 foods per stem. So this is the practice we are adapting the Maharashtra and Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. Regarding pruning, actually from that pruning, from the ground level, we can remove the excess stems, actually allowing some four stems, we can remove the other stems. So from the four stems, we can get around some 100 foods from the plant. 100 foods means we can get around some 25 kg to 40 kg per plant. Actually, we are not recommending the heavy pruning, because if we are doing the heavy pruning, it may lead to it will allow excess sun to fall on the plants. That may lead to some artificial effect to the plant. Actually, pruning is done during the dormant period. It should be confined with the previous year growth, so you need to encourage the fruiting. Actually, a set of new fruits should be allowed to develop every year on all sides of the tree, and gradual growth of the new shoots. It should be encouraged. Pruning improves the fruit number and increases the percentage of better grade of fruit. Disinfect the, actually before pruning, you have to disinfect the your pruning cicages with some Dettol or sodium hydrochloride or something. Normally, with respect to manuring and fertilization, for the first 2 years, we can give maximum of 20 kg of farmyard manure to a single plant, and followed by 250 grams of nitrogen and 125 grams of phosphorus and 125 grams of potash. From the fourth year, we can give around some 30 kg of farmyard manure and 500 grams of nitrogen and 125 grams of potash. From the fifth year onwards, you have to give around 40 kg of farmyard manure and 625 grams of nitrogen and 250 grams of potash and 250 grams of phosphorus. But the pomegranate, it is not responding to the fertilizer alone. Apart from the fertilizer, major fertilizer, we have to apply zinc sulfate, iron sulfate and manganese sulfate and boric oxide up to some particular percentage. That will increase your flower initiation and increases your yield. Then other important this thing, we have go for some autoclave, that is mulching with plastic in the basin of the plants, that will arrest your weed growth and he can go for organic mergers also. Normally, in India, we are getting foods throughout the India, but with respect of Maharashtra, they are taking foods only in the three season, that is called Aambe Bahar, Lik Bahar and Pasta Bahar. So, this three season is adopted in the Maharashtra. In the Pasta Bahar, that is in the month of October and November. In that month, that food will be affected by some blight. But if it is controlled, we can get very superior quality. So, each and every bahar, we have to some pruning and other things, and we have to apply proper fertilizer, then we can get very good yield. Normally, we can get the yield after some 130 days of flowering. Hello. Actually, this pomegranate is being affected by some pest and diseases. First and foremost, with respect to hello.
Yeah, Mr. Radhakrishnan.
Shall I continue?
Yeah, if your talk is over, then audience can ask their questions. If you would like, if you have any other information to share, please go ahead.
Yeah, I want to explain about the decision.
Okay, please go ahead.
Actually, first and foremost disease is bacterial blight. This is the number one disease all over India, throughout India we are facing. Actually, this bacterial blight, it happens in the month of, actually, if you are taking this Maharashtra, it will be happen in the month of June, July and August in the rainy season. So, bacterial blight, we can control by spraying 1% of boro mixture with along with this streptocycline 250 pm. Plus second spray you can go for first, actually whenever you face a bacterial blight problem, first spray you can give this 1% boro mixture spray. Then after some 15 days you can go for 0.25% copper oxychloride along with streptocycline during the foliage initiation. That way you can continue the boro mixture 0.4% at the 15 days interval. Then between fourth spray you can go for 250 pm of streptocycline plus carbon dioxide 0.1%. Under rainy condition, you have to spray every 10 days interval. Then only you can control the diseases. Then other fungal diseases which are affecting this pomegranate is wilt, leaf and fruit spot and phytophthora blight and fruit spot. Then this pomegranate is being affected by some disorders like tooth cracking and scaldosis, sun scald and internal breakdown. Actually, this tooth cracking is because of this bacteria blight and improper irrigation and this boron, calcium and potassium deficiency, that tooth cracking is happening. Then come to the sun scale, because of direct sun rays falling on tooth and high temperatures and excess light, drought and low humidity, which is lead to the sun scale. For that you can go for this spraying with kaolin. Then third is internal breakdown, which is because of leaf more than 140 days. Suppose if you are keeping the food more than 140 days, that will lead to the internal breakdown. Actually, so far there is no virus diseases is occurred. So there is no worry about virus disease. With respect to insect, actually this pomegranate is being majorly affected by butterfly or food borer. The food borer, that is the major this one. Actually, while food setting, these adults play, they are laying the eggs in the flowers, which will, after developing the food, is come, the larvae comes out of the food, it will spoil the entire food. So this is the major and foremost insect. Then apart from the other thing, some as usual sucking pests and some stem borers, short pole borer and leaf rooted plant bat and leaf eating caterpillar and fruit flies and food sucking moth, termite, which are affecting the our pomegranate. This is about the cultivation of pomegranate. Anybody having doubt, you can interact with me. Hello.
Yeah, thank you for the informative talk, Mr. Radhakrishnan. We have few questions from Mr. Sandeep Goel and one of our team members. What is the best variety of pomegranate for Uttarakhand region?
Actually, in India, there are so many varieties like Yarakka, Bagua, Ruby. These are the varieties being cultivated in India. Out of which in India right now, around some 80% of Indian farmers, they are doing Bagua. Hello. Hello.
Okay.
Hello. Sangeeta.
Ms. Sangeeta, if you are asking the questions via a private chat box, it will be difficult for us to read it. Can you send it to all the audience?
Hello.
Anita, are you there? Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Radhakrishnan, there is another question. What is the return from 1 acre garden of pomegranate? What is the return from 1 acre garden of pomegranate?
You are asking about development costs or what?
It is about the you can give me any both the information.
Actually, for per acre, we can need around some 400 plants. Actually, development cost, it will be around some 1.7 lakhs per acre. That is the development cost. Hello? Hello. Hello. Thank you.
Hello?
Yes,
Hello?
Sangeeta.
Yeah.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, what is the quantity and quality of the fruit received if using the tissue culture plants?
Actually, if you are using the tissue culture plant, you can get very good yield. Actually, at present, very limited company they are doing the tissue culture production. Mainly this Jain they are doing the tissue culture. Then this Cadila Pharmaceuticals they are the tissue culture this one. Then one more company from Hosur, that is Vinayaka Agro, they are doing the tissue culture pomegranate seedling.
Okay, and after how many years the pomegranate trees start giving fruits after plantation?
You can get the fruit from the 24th month.
Okay, and then how the soil can be enriched to get healthy and good quality fruits from the tree?
Actually, based on the soil test report, we can suggest
Okay,
everything is
and
depends on the soil report.
okay, and can we have access to your whole of your talk in writing? Question by Sangeeta.
Yeah.
Sangeeta, I would like to tell you where the recording of this today's talk will be uploaded on the in a discussion forum. So you can hear the talk once again, recording. Okay. Yeah, Anita, you can continue.
Yeah. I have one more question. How much is the difference between this technology and ordinary pomegranate cultivation?
Ordinary pomegranate cultivation is traditionally we are doing some 200 plants per acre. But
Okay.
in the latest technology, we are planting around some 400 plants per acre. Actually, there is no difference. But if you consider the yield, from the second year onwards, based on the quantity of plants we are doing in the plantation, accordingly we can get more yield.
Okay. Audience, please ask your questions. Sir, what is the quantity and quality of the fruit recorded if using the tissue culture plants?
Actually, there is no difference between the tissue culture plants and the ordinary plants. Only thing, in the tissue culture planting material, you can get very pure quality of the planting material, that's all. But with regards to the yield, both the tissue culture plants and the ordinary plants, both are giving same yield.
Okay. Audience, please ask the questions.
If anybody wants to ask a question, you can ask me.
Sir, would you like to share your email ID
Yeah.
so that audience can ask, email you the questions?
Shall I type it, my email ID?
Yeah, sure. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, there is one more question. What are the parameters to be checked in soil for having profitable pomegranate farming?
Actually, normally 7.5 is the ideal this thing. 7.5 pH is the ideal for pomegranate growing. But you can grow up to
Okay.
8 pH level.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Venkata, Sangeeta, any more questions? Please ask your questions.
See, if anybody is interested in pomegranate cultivation, they can straight away send query to my agency. Now I got a question, wanted to know the exact place of plantation.
Yeah.
See, it is sent by Sangeeta or what?
Sangeeta. She wanted to know where, where we can visit in Maharashtra.
In Maharashtra, you can visit Ahmednagar. Ahmednagar and Aurangabad.
Okay. And she also wanted to know the exact place of plantation.
In Ahmednagar, it is Miri. One place is called Miri. In Aurangabad, it is Jalna.
Okay. Sangeeta, I hope you got your answer. Sir, can you give any references?
References, INI forms.
Okay.
I have references now. This is INI forms.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Actually, I am expecting more query from your side, but I am not getting any query.
Yeah, yeah, sure, sir. Audience, please.
Who is on online?
Yeah, Venkata, we have not received any queries from you.
Sir.
What are the common diseases found in pomegranate trees? Now I got the query, what are the common diseases?
Yeah, actually, we have got through email.
Bacterial blight is the major disease.
Please audience, ask questions. Sir, can you tell us how much land is required for the pomegranate plantation?
That is depends upon the farmers. They can grow 1 acre, 2 acres. If they are growing very limited area, it is very difficult to marketing. Suppose if they form some group or some companies, that will be very easy for doing marketing, because with another 10 or 15 years we can get very good income. Right now.
Okay. And what is the success rate on using tissue?
There is no difference between the tissue and normal.
Okay. And one more question, sir. What are the crops which goes best with pomegranate as intercrops?
Actually, in the initial up to 6 months, you can. I am talking about the high tech cultivation. In the high tech cultivation, we are keeping 400 plants per acre.
Okay.
So you can go for intercropping only in 6 months only. You can go for any crop.
Okay.
Based on the.
Okay. And what is the best?
Yes,
sir. Yeah, what is the best planting time of pomegranate? Is June to December? Is it true? We should plant pomegranate in.
Yeah, that is a highly suitable. Yeah.
Okay.
That is a highly suitable period.
And. Okay, so you mean to say if one wants to plant, they have to wait for June to December month. So it will be
that
better
is,
yield.
Actually, that season is limited to Maharashtra, because in Maharashtra most of the farmers they are doing in the as per the Maharashtra, it is suitable for June to September. But rest part of India like Tamil Nadu or Karnataka, you can go for any time, which is respect to availability of water.
Okay. And one more question, which pomegranate variety is best suitable for Indian weather and
Bagua.
Soil?
Bagua is the number one variety, Bagua. Bagua, once again I will type.
Bagua.
Yeah.
Okay, can you type it, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually,
thank you.
Bagua is because
and we should plant
yes ma'am.
Pomegranate only through you.
Anita?
Yeah.
Let Mr. Radhakrishnan complete,
yeah.
Then you ask your questions.
Yes.
Let Mr. Radhakrishnan complete.
Okay.
Then you can ask your questions. Otherwise it's creating
okay.
confusion.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
Okay.
Actually, Bagua is the number one variety. Hello.
Okay.
Hello. You can ask
Hello?
Me the question, madam. Yeah, you can ask me the question.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Should we plant pomegranate only through using seedings? If tissue culture plants are not profitable?
Actually, pomegranate. Both tissue culture and air layering and cutting, all are profitable. But only thing in the tissue culture, you can get very few seedlings. That is the only difference.
Okay.
But with respect of yield, you can get yield all the seedlings. Whether it may be tissue culture or air layering or cuttings, but that the yielding will be same.
Uh-huh. Okay. And so from where to buy these seedlings? Any specific brand would you like to recommend?
In the Maharashtra, you can get seedlings from Jain Irrigation. If
okay.
anybody wants to get seedlings from Gujarat, they can go for Cadila Pharmaceuticals. If anybody
okay.
from Tamil Nadu, they want seedlings, they can get it from Vinayaka Agri imports from Osur.
Okay.
Yeah. Because it's Vinayaka Agri imports, they have tissue unit in Maharashtra. They are supplying the tissue plants to the Maharashtra farmers and Gujarat farmers. If anybody from Tamil Nadu, they can supply to their branches in Osur, and from the Osur branches, they can get the seedlings.
Okay.
Normally, the tissue culture plants, seedlings.